Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and I just want to do a little video on our orchard that we've been trying to get going for 3 years. It sits right beside the garden, and we put in grapes, which got totally decimated last year by the Japanese beetles. We thought we lost all of them, so we went out and bought some more, but we did have two survivors there at the end that came back. So there, we have two seedless ones I ordered through the mail, and then we went up to the farm store and got two Concord and Edelweiss or something like that, white grapes, two of each kind. And so far, and I'm afraid to say this out loud, but so far we've not seen hardly any Japanese beetles. I don't know where they are this year. Not that I miss them. I see onesies and twosies on like the corn tassels and stuff, but so far our plants are being left alone, the raspberries and the grapes. So we've got the traps ready. We bought milky spore this year. They're put down in the ground, and we're going to fight them. But we're wondering if we trapped enough last year that it significantly affected the population this year, or maybe it's the drought. I don't know, but I don't miss them. Been trying to keep up with the watering of the garden. Not an easy task. This well here, this well point was down 14 feet. It went dry. And so my husband pounded another 4 feet onto it, and the point only had, I think, 18 inches of water. It was sucking air. So he put it down 4 more feet. Now we're in water again. It's working like a charm. And bless his heart, he put a little Y thing on it right here, so I can now water 2 spots in the garden at once. And that's cutting down my watering time significantly. So I'm thrilled to death that he did that. This is the pump. Somebody asked about the pump. I don't know what it is. It's for 1-inch pipe. I don't know. I think it's a half horse. A little gas-powered pump. And it's gotten so dry that I'm nervous about setting it on the ground because it does get warm. So even though it does leak a little bit, the seal on the where you connect the hoses, I've moved it up on the tub because I don't want a grass fire out here. And I'm just hoping my neighbors get real smart about that, because my pasture is dry. They're still eating on it. They're still staying plump. But to me, it's like a big grass fire waiting to happen. And there's been grass fires all over this year in our area. Anyway, we've got blueberries, and as fast as they get ripe, the birds steal them. I'm not being greedy this year. I'm letting the birds have them because they need all the help they can get right now. And they're not mature bushes, so there's not that many. But we're having a terrible time getting them going. We ordered through the mail, and these little tiny bushes that they sent you, I don't think I'm going to see them mature in my lifetime. So, like, they're tiny. So we went to the farm store and got some bigger ones, and hopefully they will eventually take off. Frustrating. The little miniature hazelnut trees, after 3 years, they're hanging in there. They're still there. There they are, but they're not doing too much. We lost all our peaches last year. Well, one is hanging on. I'll show it to you. But so we went ahead and ordered new trees. This is the last year we're going to try this. We can get them to grow up by the house really well back here. It's just too dry. So Bear Prepper put me onto these. These are tree gators. They're like big inner tubes with 2 valves on the bottom that slowly leach the water out. You fill them like an inner tube. There's where you fill them right there. They hold 15 gallons. These are the water gator juniors. They make another one that is made for, I think, bigger trees because it's more upright against the trunk. I like these donut ones. And you fill them up, and then over 5 to 8 hours, they leach the water out. So they give a deep watering. And we're trying those. I got them for all the new trees this year. That one actually is from last year. That one did make it through the winter. These are apple trees. They don't have the tree gators because we bought these from a local orchard, and they came in old apple buckets, bushel baskets, I should say. And they seem to hold the moisture really well for them. And after a while, the baskets just disintegrate. That's what the people told me. And so we didn't put them around these. We're just going to water these. This is a surviving curl-free peach. And we thought it died, but it sent up new growth. So we're just leaving it and babying it along. I have 2 more of this variety up by the house. Golden Delicious, Macintosh, Alberta peach. These little bushes I ordered through the mail, and they were about 6 inches high when I planted them. This is their 3rd year. They've made it. These are plumberries. Bushes. I don't know if they're a berry or a plum. We'll find out. They have not produced any fruit. I'm thinking, hoping maybe next year. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 9 of them. So we'll see what happens. They even survived being mowed. This one got mowed and it sent up new growth. Sorry. we didn't have it staked. So now it has its own stake. We won't do that again. What are these? I can't remember. Plums. These are two different varieties. Stanley plum, and I forget what the other one is. Different kind of plum. My daughter wanted those. Against the fence, we have two currant bushes that the moles are wrecking havoc with, because wherever you water, the moles move in, because that's where the earthworms move in. And, oh, look. See? I don't know if you can see that, but the mole is just raising the ground up right there and cutting the roots of my plants. And then they're dying. Oh, snot. So I don't know if these currant bushes are going to make it. These are elderberries. I have three of those. Trying to get those started and going. These are two cherry bushes. I don't think they're the Nanking cherries. They're a different kind. Bush cherry of some kind. They got planted last year. They're still hanging on with us. So hopefully maybe someday we'll get cherries. But that's our little orchard that we are so hoping will take off finally. Maybe the tree gators, thank you Bear Prepper, will help. And she's planning on using those in her orchard. So good luck to her. One thing, if you do have a hand pump, I just want to mention this. And it's the kind that's open on top. You may want to think of covering that, because what happens is birds fly over. And you know what birds do. And you don't want to get your well contaminated. I didn't really worry about it, because this one's just for filling up a bucket and watering currant bushes or whatever, filling up the base there, or the container there. But the kids do drink out of it sometimes, and so, because they think it's fun. So we're covering it up, but you may want to do that, especially if you get into a situation where this is your primary water source, a hand pump. Be sure and keep it covered in the summer. And, you know, bugs or anything could go down in there, so just a FYI. And this was a bag that the tree gators came in. I saved them all because it's like a perfect fit over the pump. Okay, I really was hoping if I came out and filmed, we'd get some rain. This is ridiculous. We're not going to have any significant corn crops this year. The winter wheat, they got off the ground, I noticed, but the soybeans and the corn, especially the corn is suffering up here, just like it is all over the country. You know, guys, if you got animals like chickens and rabbits and, livestock, pigs, I would really think about storing grain right now, because the price is only going to go up. I was able to put up 127 bales of hay last night. I was thrilled to get it. My hay man saved it for me from first cutting, because I couldn't get to it. I had to work when he was doing it. And he put it in his barn for me, bless his heart. And I finally got to go get it. I was putting it up after dark. I got done at 1 a.m. because it was just cooler. And hay this year, people are on our Craigslist, need hay, desperate for hay. We'll trade horses for hay. You know, they're cutting down on their numbers of animals, and they're trading them for hay. So if you can get some and stock up as much as you can. I'm hoping we get rain and there's a third cutting. There wasn't much of a second cutting at all around here. If not, I do have a couple sources I'm going to get hay from, so I'm not real worried. But I'll tell you what, this is something I don't remember this ever being this dry, you know. And we've lived here 20 years, or over 20 years, so pray for rain. Speaking of bugs, I just have to mention this. I hate doing this because it's like jinxing myself, but I didn't have any potato bugs this year. Now, one of my life's joys is to go through the potato rows and squash potato bugs. I just get personal satisfaction out of doing that. And I didn't get to do it this year. I don't know why. I haven't seen any hornworms on the tomatoes, which I usually don't have a problem with. But the Japanese beetles and the potato bugs do usually make their appearance. I did have some white butterflies, or the cabbage moths. And I did the BT, but I didn't have to do it as much as I do in past years. They're not ravaging my plants like they do if I don't keep a steady stream of that stuff on here. So I really don't know what to think. And if I miss out on the squash bugs this year, okay, that's going to just freak me out, because I never miss out on squash bugs. But if I do, woohoo. And I don't know if it's the drought. I don't know what. But so far, we're some wood. Knock a redwood. I've not seen too many pests. Don't know why. I don't know. Maybe that's the one good thing about being in a drought. Don't know. Okay, YouTube, that's out. All I gotta move my watering apparatus to the other end of the garden and call it good. Bye-bye.